To show you how to backup your whole system and to prove that this backup approach is working, I am going to backup my whole system, then I will intentionally destroy my system and restore it from a backup. Hello everyone, it's a Linux user helping you to install, configure and use Linux. And in this video, I will show you how to backup your whole Linux system using the program rsync. rsync is a command line tool, so it is available on any Linux system. And it is a universal way to backup files on Linux. I know, not everyone is confident with Linux command line tools. And I will make a separate videos where I will show how to backup your system using graphical programs. Meanwhile, I suggest you watch this video, and maybe you will realize that the process is not that complicated, and you can also backup your system using command line. To show you how to backup and restore your system, I will use a virtual machine. So I'm gonna use this Arch Linux install within a virtual box. I'm going to connect my USB flash drive, which will simulate an external hard drive. That's how I backup my system in real life. I connect an external USB drive to my system. I will backup all the files to this USB flash drive, and then I will intentionally destroy this Arch Linux system. I will show you that it's impossible to boot in this system anymore. Then I will use the backup and restore my system, and show you that the system is working again. So you can do the same on your computer. Take any virtual machine, for example VirtualBox, install any system there, it doesn't have to be Arch Linux, you can install anything else. Then you can use rsync to backup the files. Then you can intentionally destroy your system, it's very easy, just remove some important files. And after that, you can try to restore your system from a backup. If you do this procedure from the beginning to the end, you can be confident that you know how to backup your system, and what is the most important, you know that your backup is working. Because if you have not tested your backup, it means you don't have backup. So let's start. I have noted the command here, so this is the rsync command, and you need administrative privileges to run it. And then I specify some options here. So basically these three options mean to preserve all the attributes of your files. For example, it will not modify the timestamp, ownership, permissions during the copy. Everything will be copied the same as it was on your system. So the last command means just to show the progress, so it will print on the screen what's been copied. Then I specify delete command. What it means, it will make incremental backup. So if it's your first backup, this option does nothing. But if it's your second backup, it will backup only the difference between your source and the destination. So it will backup only the new files or modified files. And it will also delete all the files in the backup which were deleted on your system. So you should be careful with this option, but it's good to use because you don't need to backup files which have not been modified. So I always use this option here. The dry run option just means to simulate the backup. So it will show you the progress of the backup and print everything in the terminal window, but nothing will be actually backupped. This option is useful to test your command. For example, if you want to make sure that all the directories which you want to exclude are excluded. Then I specify to exclude several directories here. For example, these directories are excluded because they are not very important on your system, and they are populated and used only after the boot of your system. rsync will backup these folders, but it will not backup their content. The same applies to MNT and media folder. These folders are used to mount different devices, and it's very important to exclude them because if you mount your USB drive to media or MNT, and then you start backupping your system to your USB drive, the system may get stuck in loop because it will backup to MNT and it will start backupping MNT into MNT. So it's definitely not good for your system. Then I exclude swap file because swap file is used to store temporary files. It's not necessary to backup it, you can always create it. Lost and found is the file system folder, it also can be excluded. I also exclude cache, there is nothing important in my cache. Then it depends on you. If you have something important in your downloads folder, you can keep it. But I usually don't have anything important in my downloads, so I exclude my downloads folder. I can always download things from the internet again. I also exclude my VirtualBox folder. I use my virtual machines just for test purposes and there is nothing very important there. So if I lose my virtual machine, it's not a problem for me. Besides, VirtualBox files are very large and they take time and space during the backup. If you have something important in your VirtualBox, for example if you have a Windows machine with many programs installed, then you should not exclude VirtualBox, just remove this option. The last one is to skip the encryptfs folder. This folder stores your files in encrypted format, so if you encrypted your home folder, you will have this folder. but you can exclude it because we're gonna do the backup when our home folder is unencrypted and all the files will be copied unencrypted. So it's better to encrypt your destination so you can just encrypt your whole USB drive where you do the backup, but the backed up files should be unencrypted. And then you specify the source, so basically what you want to backup, and the destination, so this is where you want to backup. So let's copy this command and paste it into our virtual machine. Then here we specify our source is our whole system, so it's our root. And in the destination we need to specify our USB drive. And the easiest way to find out the path to your USB drive is to open it when it's mounted and copy its path. Now we're gonna run this backup command as a test, so we keep the dry run option. If everything looks okay, then we can run it as a real backup. You need to enter your password because this command requires root privileges. And as you can see, backup is in the progress. Now everything is finished and it was dry run, so nothing has been backed up. For example, we can open our USB drive. And as you can see, it's empty, nothing backed up here. So everything looks normal, you can just screen if you want and see if everything was backed up as you wanted. If you see, for example, here that some folders which you wanted to exclude, but they appear during the backup, you need to go back and check your exclude option. Maybe you forget to specify something or you made a type or something else. So we go back to our command. If you press the arrow key up, it will show you the previous command. And then we remove the dry run option. So now we will run this command as a real backup command. And again, check your source and destination. The source is our whole system and the destination is our flash drive, which is mounted here. Now, this is the progress of a real backup. So if we open our USB drive, you see our system is backing up here. It takes quite a while to backup the whole system. It is also very important to use some Linux file systems on your USB drive, because if you use FAT file system, rsync won't be able to copy all the file attributes, because FAT file system doesn't support some of them. So format your USB drive with XT4 for example. So now the backup is complete, there were no errors, and around 4 gigs of files have been copied. If we go back to our flash drive, we can see all the files here. And if you remember, I excluded some files during the backup. For example, the temp folder was excluded. If we go here, it's empty. But if we go into temp folder on our system, you can see there are some files here. So the backup is complete now. Let's destroy our system and try to restore it from a backup. I'm not going to remove many files from my system because it will take a lot of time to restore them back. But if I remove the boot directory, it will be enough to destroy the system and it will not be bootable. So I open terminal here. So again, you see these are our directories. And then I run sudo remove boot. And we also need to add option force and recursively. Now there is no boot directory and it disappeared from here. So if I reboot now, the system probably won't boot anymore. Yes, as you can see here, the system doesn't boot because the boot directory is not found. I'm going to boot from a live ISO. In your case, you need to boot from a live USB. If you don't know how to create a live USB, I have a separate video on this topic. The link is in the description. So I'm going to mount Arch live ISO. And I'm also gonna check that my USB drive is also mounted here. Then I'm going to reset my system. And now I'm going to boot from Arch live ISO. So now we need to do two things. We need to mount our system and our USB drive. And then we need to restore the backup from our USB drive into our system. To do that, we need to create two folders where we're going to mount our devices. Now we need to check the names of our devices. And as you can see, SDA1 is our system because it's 10 gig size. And SDB1 is a USB drive because I know that it's 15 gigs. Your system probably will be bigger than 10 gigs, it's just a test machine here. So I am going to mount my system to the system folder and the USB device to the USB folder. You can enter these directories and check what files are there. For example, in the system folder, you can see that this is our system without the boot folder. And if you go to the USB folder, you can see that this is a backup of our whole system, including the boot directory. So now let's restore the backup. You need to use the same rsync command, except you don't need to exclude many directories here. It's enough to exclude lost and found, because it's a file system directory. You also need to specify the option delete, because you want to restore only the files which have been deleted, not everything. And in our source, we specify the USB drive, and in our destination, we provide the system folder. And it is also important to remove the slash in the end of the system directory, because otherwise rsync will create a USB directory within the system directory and restore everything there. But this is not what we want. So the restore process is complete. We can go back to our system and check if the boot folder has been restored. And as you can see, the boot folder is there. So now we need to reboot, and hopefully we will be able to boot back to our system. If you have not removed your Arch Linux Live ISO, you can choose to boot to existing OS from the menu here. Yeah, as you can see, it complains that swap file was not activated because we have not restored our swap file. So we can restore it manually. I have a video where I show how to make a swap file on Linux system. And as you can see, I have restored my system and it's working. Now to double check it, let's remove our Arch ISO and reboot the system. Yes, everything is working. So this is the standard procedure to restore a system from a backup. The only case I have not covered here is if you have damaged your bootloader and then the system doesn't boot. Because this backup may not restore your bootloader and you need to install it manually, but this is a topic for another video. Now you know how to backup your whole Linux system on any Linux distribution. I hope this video was useful. If it's your first time on the channel, please subscribe. I upload new Linux videos every Wednesday and Friday. Thank you for watching.